So, hello students. Today I'm going to discuss about red lesions of oral mucosa. Myself, Dr. Saithi, team MDS Concur. So these are actually, the red lesions are broadly classified as reactive lesions, inflammatory lesions, pre-malignant and malignant lesions, immunological lesions, metabolic lesions, vascular lesions and infective conditions. And there are some others also. So coming to each in detail. So first is a reactive, which is a pyogenic granuloma. So it is actually a deep reddish lesion which occurs on the gingiva and it is either sessile or pedunculated and it shows severe bleeding tendency. So actually the causative agent could be any calculus and also any foreign material which is present in the gingival crevix, and also the hormonal changes which occur in the puberty and pregnancy can also be one of the causative agent for pyogenic granuloma. So next is a peripheral giant cell granuloma, which is embedded with multinucleated giant cell and it is supposed to be arising from the periodontal ligament which is present enclosing to the root of the tooth. So these two are actually the reactive lesions. So coming to the clinical features, it appears as a reddish blue with broad base and superficial ulcerations. It's most common in females and it arises from the periodontium. So this is very important. Other than pyogenic granuloma, even this is very important reactive lesion which is arising from the periodontal ligament and is associated with the root. So coming to the inflammatory lesions, which includes a chemical burn or a thermal burn, wherein the patient will give history of the exposure to a hot food or something, and also exposure to any chemical or long-term exposure chemical like aspirin. So this can cause any coagulative necrosis, leaving an erythematous macule after scraping. So it shows a coagulative necrosis, and when it is scraped, it shows an erythematous area. So coming to its clinical features, it is again red area, which is painful. It even shows bleeding on slight manipulation. And the size and shape corresponds to the area of contact with the causative agent. So common site is the palatal mucosa and the buccal mucosa. So next, coming to the pre-malignant lesion. So reactive lesions and inflammatory lesions is done. So coming to the reactive lesion, pre-malignant lesion, which is an erythroplakia. It is a form or a type of leukoplakia wherein it can has a or it has a tendency to convert into malignancy. So even it shows a typical reddish lesion. So main thing you have to remember, it is associated with malignancy, that is 14 to 50%. So a malignancy association percentage you have to remember. So even it shows dysplastic features. So coming to the next pre-malignant lesion, which is erosive lichen planus, even it has erythematous area with reddish lesion with peripheral striae, and it is the second most type, which is next to the reticular type, and it can 1 to 2.5% squamous cell carcinoma. Next is erythema multiforme, where it shows target lesions, and especially coming to the oral cavity, it shows hemorrhagic incrustations of the lips. So here the target lesions, the center is a ruptured bullae followed by the pair erythematous zone, and around which is a peripheral erythematous zone. So this is a target lesion. This three is a characteristic features which is related to the target iris or the bullae appearance, which is seen in the erythema multiforme. And orally, hemorrhagic incrustations of the lip is very important. So pemphigus, as I already discussed in the disease of the skin, even it shows a flaccid bullae which ruptured and leaves an ulcerative lesion with tissue tags. So tissue tags are present around the erythematous reddish lesion. So this is an important feature for pemphigus. So coming to the metabolic thing, vitamin D deficiency, the oral and the changes shows chelitis and glossitis, especially the riboflavin deficiency. The tongue becomes red with atrophy of the papillae and also shows severe burning sensation. Pernicious anemia, even it shows effect on the tongue and reddish lesions. Other findings are weakness, pallor, shortness of breath, and CNS manifestations like dizziness and tinnitus, and GIT manifestations are also there. Coming to the oral cavity, red atrophic tongue, which is called as Hunter's or Moeller's glossitis, which is very important. So Hunter's or Moeller's glossitis, it appears as a red tongue. So that's the reason even this is included in the metabolic under metabolic thing for the red lesions. So coming to the iron deficiency, even it shows red depapillated tongue. So that's the reason it is included under red lesions. And because of inadequate dietary intake or impaired absorption of the iron, also because of blood loss, menstrual problems and GIT bleeding and aspirin ingestion, can cause iron deficiency anemia. Clinical features can show shows predominantly in the woman. If the aspirin is actually used as a chemical agent locally, then it results in chemical burn. Okay, if it is ingested as a chronic drug or if the patient is using a long-term systemic aspirin, then it can cause iron deficiency anemia, which results in red tongue or a red depapillated tongue. The other features include sparse hair and brittle nails, collinicias, and that is spoon-shaped nails, and red depapillated tongue and angular chelitis. So we already discussed about the burning mouth syndrome, which is actually mostly in psychogenic origin, and there is no typical oral mucosal lesions, but at times it can show redness or slight reddish lesion with stinging or burning sensation affecting the oral mucosa. The glossopyrosis is seen in burning mouth syndrome. So even that can be included under red lesions. So coming to the various vascular lesions, which includes the hemangioma and vascular malformations. These are the developmental anomalies of the blood vessels or... So here the congenital hematoma, it's seen in the childhood and infancy due to proliferation of endothelial cells, whereas the vascular malformation is abnormal morphogenesis of arterial and venal structures. So coming to the different clinical features, it is most often seen on the tongue with reddish, bluish or purplish soft lesions, which are usually painless. The characteristic feature is the blanch on pressure. So this is the main important feature, and microscopically the capillary or cavernous endothelium lined blood vessels, which are can be seen. So the blood vessels and that can be seen in microscopically. The characteristic feature is reddish lesion which blanch on pressure. So coming to the vascular malformations, so these lesions are actually through the vessels, predominantly arteries and veins. The signs or symptoms are actually related to the site, shape and degree of shunting within the mass. So physiologically, they are classified as high flow, high shunting, low or low flow, low shunting. So what is the major differences between the hemangioma and vascular malformation? You have to have an idea. So this important box, note it down, the main important features. So hemangioma shows abnormal endothelial cell proliferation, whereas vascular formation shows abnormal blood vessel development, and this is because of increased capillaries. Here it is mix of arteries, veins and capillaries. It shows rapid congenital growth. It grows with the patient. The boundaries is often circumscribed. Here it is poorly circumscribed. There is no associated thrill, whereas here it can produce a thrill or a bruite. Next, it undergoes spontaneous involution. It doesn't involute or it doesn't regress. So resection is persistent. Lesions are resectable. It is very difficult to resect. So recurrences is uncommon, whereas recurrences is common. So basic difference between hemangioma and malformation, you have to remember, it's very important. So next is the infectious, that is scarlet fever. The scarlet fever, it's caused by bacterial beta hemolytic streptococci. So this, the different clinical features, associative fever, pharyngitis, tonsillitis, lymphadenitis and headache. So here on the third day of the fever, the patient can present with strawberry tongue. Whereas on the fifth day of fever, the patient shows red beefy tongue, which is called as a raspberry tongue. And apart from these, it shows pasthia lines over the skin folds, and also goose pimples can be seen. Okay, these are the different features. So strawberry tongue on the third day, raspberry tongue on the fifth day, and on this, coming to the skin lesions, it includes the pasthia lines and goose pimples. Pasthia lines on the skin folds and also goose pimples with the sandpapery texture is common in scarlet fever. So coming to the other infectious, that is candidiasis, erythematous candidiasis, especially the patients having ill-fitting dentures and long-term usage of dentures, the patients who have habit of wearing the dentures throughout the night can harbor the candida albicans, and which results in the erythematous candidiasis. So even this is included under the red lesions. So treatment is of candidiasis, you can go with a nystatin topical therapy, and also you can, if it is severe, you can go for fluconazole or itraconazole you can give. So other one infectious is a Kaposi's sarcoma, which is caused by herpes virus, virus 8. So herpes, human herpes virus 8, even this is malignant and it originates in the vascular endothelium, and it also shows a typical reddish lesion. So coming to the other forms, that is petechiae, these are a pinpoint hemorrhages which occurs in subcutaneous and submucosal structures with varying conditions. So etiology could be viral, can be thrombocytopenia and leukemia, or disseminated intravascular coagulation, or any trauma. So ecchymosis, these are larger size when compared to petit K. So it can be non-elevated, rounded, or irregular blue or purple patch. So clinical presentation, these are larger than the pinpoint. It's non-vascular and macular surface. Lesions do not blanch on pressure. They are reddish to brownish in color. So petit K, ecchymosis, and purpura. All these are also different reddish lesions. So benign migratory glossitis, we know, also called as erythema migrans or geographic tongue. It shows serpiges border over the tongue, which are also erythematous depapillated areas of the tongue are seen. So even it appears as reddish lesion. So thank you. These are the different reddish red lesions of the oral cavity. Almost all you know, but you just go to the classification which I have given in the initial slide. That was very useful. So what are reactive, what are inflammatory, what are pre-malignant, what are immune mediated, like the erosive lichen planus or pemphigus, or even erosive lichen planus can come under pre-malignant as well. So inflammatory, reactive, pre-malignant, infectious, autoimmune, and others. So the main classification, if you have an idea, that's more than enough. So this is a brief description of all the red lesions of the oral cavity. Thank you once again.